Mr. Satish H.S., Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, NIE, Mysore. So today we are going to make a video on General Engineering Practice, that is GEP Lab. As you all know, by now we have a situation in India which is COVID-19. So because of that, students, my friends, are not able to come to the college, and we are making this video on behalf of the college, on behalf of the department. We are making this video to make sure you don't miss the classes, so you feel the class and you can understand the concepts clearly. So, right? So in this GEP lab, so as you all know, we have three important modules: fitting, welding, and sheet metal. So in this semester, students have already done with fitting. Done with fitting means they have already done some models. They know the procedure, how to do the model by using the files, by doing the filing operation, and they know somehow, they know how to do a welding. In sheet metal, we have taught you theoretically how to develop any given models for you, but you have not practically seen or practically done with a development or a work with sheet metal. So because of that, we are making this video to make sure you come across a sheet metal work, how to do a work on sheet metal. So before actually going into the video, I just want to give a small message to my viewers, my students, just to stay safe, stay home. So maintain social distancing, right? With this simple small message, I will start with the video. And to start with the video, once again, I just want to refresh what we have studied about development. So what is a development? So what is development? A development is nothing but opening the face. So cutting at one end and opening the face, or opening the lateral surface, or I can say unfolding a surface, is called as a development. And why it is being required and where we use this development. So in almost all the automobiles, in chimneys, in boilers, whatever the industries you can take, in all the industries we may come across this development things. Not only in the industries, we as a person in our childhood, we have been doing the development concept where we used to wrap our books using a wrapper, right? So we, you know how to do the development. But on the sheet metal, how to do a development is a concept from me. So today what I will do, I will take a simple example of a cylinder and I will try to explain how to do a development of a sheet metal, right? So we will consider, a small cylinder having certain dimensions, and also we assume this cylinder to be a hollow cylinder neglecting the top and bottom surfaces. Therefore, if you can see a cylinder, it is a complete through hole form, right? There is no top surface, there is no bottom surface, only the lateral surface is been there for me, only the lateral surface. Only this lateral surface will be developed, and I will try to make this model with a separate sheet metal. So to start with development of this sheet metal now, first I will try to write the orthogonal views, which is the front and top view of this simple object, in this case a cylinder, right? So a cylinder in the front view, how does it look? It is just a rectangle. Therefore what I will do, I will first write an XY line. So once I write the XY line, I will try to write the front view of a cylinder, which is a rectangle for me, having a height which has been specified for me in my manual of 40 mm, and this width depends on the diameter of the circle, which can be seen at the top, which is a diameter of 30 mm they have given. Therefore in my orthogonal views, I will write initially the front view and the top view with the given dimension of 40 mm and 30 mm. Remember, it is in hollow cylinder, it is not having the top and bottom surfaces. You are only going to develop this lateral surface. Now what is the development of this cylinder? How to get the development of this cylinder? So to get the development of a cylinder, I need to cut the cylinder at one end, I need to open the cylinder, right? So you can see here, I have a model right now in front of me. There is a cylinder for me. So I will cut the cylinder at one end, and I will try to open the cylinder. Right? I am trying to open a cylinder now. So what you can see now? So it is a cylinder before. I have cut the cylinder and I am opening the cylinder. It is getting me a bigger rectangle. Right? I am getting a rectangle once again having certain height and certain width. What is this height and what is the width? That is my question, right? So as you can see, when I cut this cylinder, if I open or unfold the cylinder, height of this one remains the same, which is 40 mm. But the width, as you can see, the width is the one which I need to do the calculations, right? So for any given cylinder, to find the developed part, which is height and width, I need to do the calculation. So how to do the calculation? You can see from the top view, it is a circle. So if I am cutting at one end and if I am opening this circle, then this circle will reappear me like a straight line, right? Which is nothing but circumference of a circle, correct? If I open this one, if I cut at this point, and if I open this one, it will be a straight line where the length of the line is equal to the circumference of the circle. So what is the circumference of a circle formula? So you have studied in a basic schools, the circumference of a circle is being given by the formula 2 pi r or equal to pi d, right? 2 pi r or equal to pi d. In this case, they have given the diameter directly. Therefore, I will use the formula pi d to calculate what is the width of the rectangle. So I have got the dimensions, I got the pi, I do the calculations, I do the math, I will get 94.24 as the dimension. With these dimensions, having height 40 and width L is equal to 94.24 mm, I will try to construct a rectangle which is nothing but developing a circle or a development of this cylinder. So dimensions what I have taken for this cylinder, the development is this rectangle what you are going to see, where the height is 40 mm and the width is 94.24 mm, right? That is my development part. Now I need to bend the sheet. I need to bend the sheet in such a way that I need to obtain a circle of diameter 30 mm. That is, I've got the sheet metal, I've got the dimensions, I've got the dimensions of 40 mm and 94.24. Now my next step is to, I need to bend, not through the hand, through some tools, right? I need to bend in such a way that I need to get a dimension of 30 mm. By using the sniper or by using the mallet, I am going to get this object done. So having the dimensions of 30 mm and 40 mm height, right? So when I do that model, when I bend this sheet metal into a cylinder, so this is the shape what I am going to get. But when I release the force, this cylinder will be distorted and will not be in position. To make sure this cylinder is in position, I need to give some hemming or interlocking. You can just see my hand is there. So my hand is there. When I move my hand across like this, there is no interlocking system that's been given over there, and therefore my hand is sliding. When I fold my hand, you can see now there is interlocking system, therefore my hand cannot move freely, and therefore I can say the position is locked. Similarly, in this figure also, there is no interlocking systems which has been given, and therefore what happens when I am going to bend the sheet metal, this position will not be maintained. If I want to forcibly maintain this position, then diameter is lost, correct? So in order to make sure, I need to get this one, I am going to leave some extra 5 mm and extra 10 mm on either sides, and henceforth I can make locking to be done. And this extra 5 mm and extra 10 mm is called as hemming, a single hemming and double hemming. This is only done because to maintain the shape of the cylinder to be at the exact given dimension. To only to maintain at exact given dimension, so I am providing this hemming at either sides, one of 5 mm and one side of 10 mm, a single hem and double hem. Therefore, I can lock this cylinder or a sheet metal. This is what actually we are going to give. And for students, so what you need to do, so what you need to do before coming to the slab, when the college reopens, what you need to do is, you need to draw these diagrams. Not just diagrams, you need to draw the developments. So they have given some problems in your manual about the cylinder, about the cone, truncated cone, then about the tray. Three developments you need to draw. What you need to do is, on the space provided, you need to draw the orthogonal views. You need to calculate the dimensions. Once you calculate the dimensions, then beside the orthogonal views, you need to draw the development. Remember, this is the rectangle which is the development. And this hashed portions, what you can see on either sides, it is given for the hemming. So you need to draw a 94.24 plus 5 plus 10 on either sides to complete your development. This is first step. So you will draw this development in your book. And second step is, once again, you need to take a sheet of paper, A4 size sheet. On that A4 size sheet, you need to draw only the development part. Why? Because only this development part is taken, and this development part is pasted on the sheet metal what we provide to you. We will paste the development what you have written, then we will cut the sheet metal with the help of a knife, then we are going to bend the sheet metal, just like this. You can see, on a sheet metal, I have pasted a sheet of paper. It's just not a sheet of paper. It is having a length equal to 94.24 plus 5 and plus 10. So complete dimension is made and it is being cut into given dimension, and then it is being pasted over the sheet metal. So that is why you need to write two sets of development, one in the manual and one in a sheet of paper A4 unrolled size, because you need to paste it on the sheet metal. Then that will be bent using some tools, sheet metal tools, and henceforth the final model can be obtained. Right? So now what we will do, we will take a short movement and we will go into the sheet metal area and we will try to make this model with the help of a sheet metal. Right? So I hope you understood how to do a development. In a short movement, we will try to see how this model is being made from the development what we have written. Thank you. Welcome. So welcome once again to the video. So we have seen the theory of the cylinder. So how to develop a cylinder, you have seen the theory, and you also drawn the thing on the sheet of paper. Now what you are going to see is, now we are going to see how to bend the sheet metal. So what is the sheet metal? You can see in my hand there is a sheet of metal, and this is called as sheet metal for me, and it is having a gauge of 28. That means in millimeters I can say it is having a thickness of around 0.12 or 0.15 millimeters here, right? So I need to, now you can see the sheet has to be bent into a circular way. To do that one, I have different tools I am going to use, and different tools what I am going to use here is, important is the snipe. So this is called as a snipe, so it is being used to cut this material. So what actually we do is, so once we draw the development, we are going to stick the development on the sheet metal. So once we stick the development on the sheet metal, we take the help of a knife to cut the sheet metal. Then once again we take the help of mallet, stakes, different types of stakes are there, you can see here. So different types of stakes are there. Along with that, we also have a nose plier. So this is called as nose plier. With along all these tools, I will try to bend this sheet metal into the required shape. So only thing we need to understand here is, stakes has been used to make sure the metal is being drawn or is being bent to the required shape. And snipe is being used to cut the materials, because we cannot use a normal scissors to cut a sheet metal. It's a metal thing, so you cannot cut any of the metal with the help of scissors. Henceforth, we use a knife to cut the material, and mallet and stakes and nose plier to form the sheet metal, that is to bring the sheet metal into the required shape. Now we are going to see a small demo video on how to convert the sheet metal into the required hollow cylinder. Now you can see the sheet metal has been cutting through the help of a knife over there. As you can see now, the surgeon is cutting the sheet metal. Also you can see the development disc is being pasted on the sheet metal. So it's already been pasted and the sheet metal is being cutted using the help of knife. Now the sheet metal has been brought to the required shape, along with the hemming and everything is being brought to the required shape. Now you can see it's actually flattening the sheet metal because it's been distorted, and henceforth what actually is doing is with the help of a mallet is flattening the sheet metal, also is bending the corners which is being provided for hemming. So once the edges has been bent, then it will take the further to bend the sheet. Now you can see the hem has been bent. Now it is bending the sheet metal to give the shape of a cylinder. Now by using the nose plier, he is hemming the sides or the edges on the both the sides. Hemming process has been taking place so that both the edges are intact. There should be no loose ends, therefore both the ends should be hemmed. That is the lock which has been filling for you. Once the lock has been obtained, then we will go for the further operation. Now you can see once the hemming has been done, now the sheet metal is being placed on a rod to give a circular Now the sheet metal is being hammered by using a mallet to give circular orientation. It is now where you can see sheet metal is being getting its shape of circular. Now you can see a finished product, a finished model of the sheet metal cylinder, hollow cylinder. So this is a simple method to show you how you can convert a flat sheet metal into a circular hollow cylinder.